So I know you all have been waiting for long, and we have had a very, very fruitful morning. So once you have done with the photos, we'll start with the proceedings. Shuru karein ab? Okay. So as I was saying, we had a very, very fruitful morning where we went to the field with Twinkle, who joins us today as an artist ambassador for Save the Children to champion the cause of adolescent health and menstrual hygiene. And before we hear from her, Saleha, we would like to invite our head of state, Maharashtra State, to talk a bit about our work with our partner, Apnalaya, in Mumbai, and with a focus on adolescent health and menstrual hygiene. Sanjay, could we have you here?
Thank you, Pragya. And dear friends from media, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you, a good afternoon, and I welcome you for this event. And it gives me a great pleasure, and I'm really happy to honor and like welcome our guest on the dais today. We have Twinkle Khanna, the author, columnist, filmmaker, and actress. And now like she's joining Save the Children as the brand ambassador. So we welcome you, ma'am, to Save the Children family. I also welcome Ms. Bidisha Pillai. She is the CEO of Save the Children in India. Welcome to Arun, who is our partner, Apnalaya, in Mumbai. And I also welcome our young child champion, Saleha Khan. So you all are most welcome to this event. Friends, I'll quickly, like, you know, talk about Save the Children work in Maharashtra and about the overall situation of health hygiene and child production in country and in Maharashtra. So you all know, like, Maharashtra is the second largest state in the country. And if we see the census data, so there's around 33% population which is below the age of 18. So it's a young state. And if we see the population of the adolescents and then the young women, so there's around 19 million adolescents and young women in Maharashtra. And the state is doing great, like in terms of the economic growth. But unfortunately, like, you know, this growth has not transmitted, like, you know, in terms of the human development indicators. So still we have, like, you know, one out of three children are malnourished. Every second girl is anemic. And then there's a government report which says that, you know, around 50 to 60% girls, they stop going to the school during the period. And also, like, you know, there's poor access to the sanitary facilities and sanitation pad. So the situation is not so good. It's leading child right organization in the world. And in Maharashtra, we work with the state government. We work with the civil society organization, with the community, and directly with the children's. And there's so many like child champions like Saleha we have today here. So like, you know, if I talk about, like, you know, our work in Maharashtra, health and hygiene, child production, education is one of our priority. And we are really grateful that like Twinkle is with us to endorsing this cause. Last year alone, we reached around 20,000 children's and family on health and hygiene production and education issue in Maharashtra. And this is in somewhere around 500 schools and around 100 localities, including urban and poor, and in four districts. So this is a great work which Save the Children doing in Maharashtra. We are very, like, you know, closely working with the state government. We are the technical partner for the various department. And a recent project which Save the Children started for the, you know, the urban children, that is, like, we are helping to give the identity to somewhere around 80,000 children who live in the street situation in Maharashtra and linking them with the various social protection schemes. So there are a lot of other programs also, and it's really privileged, like, you know, and that we all are gathered here and we are discussing, and we'll talk more about, like, you know, our association with the Save the Children program. Friends, in last, like, you know, many of you, I think, are aware that, like, you know, this week, every year, the 14th to 21st of November, we celebrate the United Nations Convention for the Child Rights Week. So it's a UNCRC week. And every year, like, so this convention happened in year 1989, where 194 countries come together, and they pass a charter, a declaration about the children's right. And it's a legal document. So India is also one of the signatory to this document. And the government is legally, you know, binding to follow that and develop the policies on the health and hygiene for the children's welfare and to implement the program. So this is the occasion of the UNCRC Child Right Week. And we are, like, you know, really grateful that, like, on this occasion, we are announcing our partnership with Twinkle. The second thing, like, you know, we work with in partnership with many organizations. Arun is with us here, like, you know, so Apnalaya is working with us to create the child champions and, like, on health and hygiene issue in Mumbai. Similarly, like, you know, we have many partners in the different part of the Maharashtra and in the country. So this all is about the partnership. And if you ask me, like, you know, with my last 20 years of experience on working with the children, so this all is partnership. Everybody has a role to play. And if we'll come together, then only we can provide a better future to our children. So I'll end here. Like, you know, thank you so much for coming here. And then you will listen more about, like, you know, from our celebrity, our CEO, and, you know, other dignitaries on the dais. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sanjay. And I think as Sanjay was talking about urban, we often feel that the problems are lying out there in the rural India, and that's where the challenges are. But little do we know that urban is a milieu which requires much more attention, and we need to prioritize, because whether it's human indicators, whether it's about social development, that's really the need of the hour, to look at the urban scenario and how do we take that along with a rural focus. With that, I would like to invite Bidisha to tell you a little more about Save the Children, why adolescent health is so important for the organization, and formally welcome Twinkle as our partnership with Twinkle Khanna as an artist ambassador to champion the cause of adolescent health and hygiene. Over to Bidisha.
Can I speak from here?
Yeah, yeah.
Is it on?
Yeah. All right, thank you so much. Can you all hear me? All right, super. Thank you all again from all of us for being here this afternoon. As Sanjay said, this week is a special week. It is. This is when we celebrate the birth of the United Nations Convention of Child Rights. And why that is so special is the UNCRC was actually born out of the work of our founder. Save the Children's founder was this feisty woman called Eglantine Jebb, who founded Save the Children nearly 100 years ago. Next year we're going to be 100 years in the aftermath of the war, when she saw the impact that the war was having on the lives of children. And that is how Save the Children was born. And it is in the work of Save the Children, from the work of Save the Children, from the work of that one woman, Eglantine Jebb, that the UNCRC was actually crafted, and many countries actually have now signed up to and adopted that. So it is a very significant moment, I think, for all of us within SAFE, but also definitely all of us who are working in partnership, as Sanjay rightly said, on the issues of child rights. Our work, our endeavor, globally and in India, even after these 100 years, is to ensure that every child enjoys their right to survive, to learn, to thrive, and enjoys their right to participation as well, so to participate in their own development and in their own growth. And in this process, of course, we want to go along and find more people who are like-minded, who are working on the similar issues. So when it comes to adolescence, what does that have to do with survival and learning and thriving and participation? I would say it has everything to do with all of those things. Because if you look at the age of adolescence, if you look at from when a child is between the ages of 10 to 19, which is how adolescence is typically sort of defined, there are three things, I think, that come to my mind. We've all been adolescents, first of all, and we will know how difficult it is to be a teenager or to be an adolescent. That is the time when your body is going through a lot of changes. So there are physical changes, there are hormonal changes, there are emotional changes, there are needs that you have. And it's a really, really difficult time for the organization. The body is growing and developing, so the need for nutrition, for access to good quality health, good hygiene, good sanitation, protection from issues of violence is probably, that is probably the crux. And why it is the crux is, at the end of the day, when that young adolescent girl or boy grows up, and for the girls, goes on to be a mother and goes on to be, you know, an equal or take her equal place in society, and for the boys to be a productive part of society as well and to respect women, what they learn, what they do, the quality of health and nutrition they get is absolutely key. So it is a critical time, but it is also an opportune time. So if we are able to focus on adolescents and help them at that point of time to get access to the right kind of health, to the right hygiene, to the right awareness about their own rights, thank you. So if we are able to use that opportunity to really provide not just them with the right kind of health and nutrition, but really with the agency, with the self-efficacy, to be able to be aware of their rights and also the confidence to be able to stand up and claim those rights, not just for themselves, but also for the peers around them, I think is a huge opportunity. When they go on in life, they will be able to negotiate how they are treated within the home as women, as wives, as daughters-in-law. They will be able to negotiate whether the child should go to school, the girl child should go to school. They will be able to negotiate family planning choices for themselves. They will also be able to negotiate, quite frankly, how the family income is spent and on what it is spent. So I think that age, therefore, is absolutely critical, and that is why we think it is so important for us to be focusing more and more on the adolescent population. And the third thing that I think is critical for adolescents is when we work with children like Saleha, or young children like Saleha. The whole point about participation, about saying that what I can do as a 40-year-old woman who's a mother of adolescents is very different to what a Saleha, who is 15 or 16 years old, can do, and the impact she can have on the lives of the children around her is significantly different. When Saleha goes and talks to her peers, they listen. When Saleha goes and talks to the mothers of her peers or fathers of her peers, they listen. When Saleha goes and talks to policymakers and tells them that this is what we demand, this is what I need, this is what children like me in my community need, they sit up and listen. And I think that is the impact that we can have. That I think is the greatest, most significant impact that we can have when we work on empowering our adolescents with the skills of influencing, of negotiation, of understanding their bodies, of being able to stand up and claim their rights. And that's the cycle in which we want to work, have been working, and have brilliant champions, not just like Saleha, but really if I look at it from Govandi in Mumbai to Sundarbans in West Bengal, and quite literally Jammu and Kashmir in the north to most recently Kerala in India, where we are present in the aftermath of the floods. The whole approach for us is looking at children at the center, placing their needs at the center, and then working with the children and the communities to be able to stand up and understand and claim their rights. So I think when it comes to us, we've been doing this for ages. Arun has been doing this for ages. Apnalai has been doing this for ages. But when we find people who are outside the so-called, you know, civil society space, who sort of reflect and mirror the same passion, the same commitment, the same buy-in to principles, people like Twinkle, I think it's a real, we see that as a real gift. And we see it as a way for not just us, but really for children like Saleha, their voices to be amplified, the impact of the work they are doing to be you know, sort of manifold 10 times. Because what we can do with our limited resources is probably reach those 35,000, work with those 35,000 child champions and you know, work with the 800 change makers within our communities. But when someone like a Twinkle comes on board and joins forces with us to champion not just what she believes in, but what is reflected therefore in a lot of the work that we are doing, I think it adds a huge, huge impetus to our work. So a very, very warm welcome to you, Twinkle, to come on board as Save the Children's Artist Ambassador and work with us on adolescent health. I think it's a crucial, crucial issue. As we were hearing this morning from the field, it is an issue which is not much spoken about. A lot of you are many, many years younger than me, but I do remember that even when we were growing up, it was not an issue that was talked about openly at the dinner table. But we're able to do that now at our dinner table in our homes. Mm-hmm. And the fact that Saleha is able to do that within her home as well, I think is a huge achievement. So I think it's certainly a critical issue. We are committed to working on issues like that, along with partners like Apnalay, who've been absolutely brilliant over the last 8-10 years that we've worked with them. And we're delighted, actually, to have Twinkle come on board as an ambassador. So thank you very much.
Before we move with the proceedings, could I request, Rachit, there's a small token from Save the Children as we welcome you on board, something that will remain with you as who we are. Can we give it to Vidisha and Saleha and Arun to present this to Twinkle? Oh, you want to know what's in it? So this is basically the founder of our organization 100 years ago was a woman, Eglantine Jebb. So we have tried to incorporate her quotes in little things like a notebook, things that we use on a daily basis, a mug that she can sip a cup of coffee in. So simple things like that, that will stay with her on a daily basis, on a day-to-day basis. So nothing fancy, but a reminder of who we are and where we go. So, can we have the film, Rachit? So there is a little film that we have put together just to announce, just to sum up the first segment of our conversation and for everyone to see. So we've been hearing about inspiring change. We are talking about young change makers like Saleha, and not just her, creating a millions of them to create a magical movement of change, which doesn't happen overnight. And I would like to invite Arun, who is the CEO of our partner organization, Apnalay. And they are closest to the field who we have collaborated with, and we work with them on a regular basis. To talk about, of course, this partnership, but more importantly, to talk about what it takes to combat the challenges that community faces, children like Saleha face, and how do we overcome that to create such amazing, stellar champions like Saleha and many, many like Salehas. We don't want one Saleha, we want hundreds and thousands and millions. So with that, if I could invite Arun to, would you like, yeah, you could talk from there. Yeah, perfectly fine.
Thank you, Pragya. I'm delighted to be here in front of you. A couple of things about the partnership first. It's 9 years old now. When we started working with Save the Children in Govandi, 60% of deliveries used to take place in homes. And you know what home means in the context of Govandi. It's 15x10. Blue sheet, thatched houses, 5 people in the same room. More than 63% people, children who were born, were malnourished. We have brought it down to 46 from 63. Today, more than 96% deliveries take place in hospitals, in institutions, not in homes. Only 23% people were vaccinated, children were vaccinated. Today, that percentage has gone up to 63. So there have been changes in AMIST ward.
The challenges are quite severe. I do not know how many people know about MIST ward as closely as they should, as proud Mumbaikers. The human indicators are not good. They have improved, but still they are worse than the worst sub-Saharan African cases, for instance. According to United Nations Development Project Report 2009, the life expectancy in MIST ward is 39. This is a kind of, I don't know, well-kept secret or something that we certainly don't talk about much. So I think the partnership with Save the Children is significant, not only because of what we have managed to achieve, but also what we have, we feel, managed to convince a partner that it requires a long-term investment to make changes in a community which is so deprived. We seek to do that because we feel that there is no alternative to any sustainable development. And I think that can come only if we have young people moving in, taking care of their, you know, their community. We invest a lot in what we call a citizenship program. The idea basically is to tell people, enable people to understand their rights and responsibilities, help them understand what government schemes are, what social entitlements are, and learn how to work with the government, different departments, so that those basic rights which are not available right now, the young people will be able to seek them in future. And that's the way we have moved out of various communities where we have worked since 1973. Gwandi remains a challenge for its own reason. One is the open landfill, for instance. There is no other place where Mumbai can throw its garbage. That's what it seems like. We've been talking about decentralized, for instance, disposal of garbage, but it hasn't happened yet. But that's the only way we can deal with it. We cannot assume there'll be a place where the entire Mumbai can go and throw its garbage. It's just not going to work. And that results into all kinds of health-related challenges. What we are dealing with since last 43 years is that there is an intergenerational cycle of marginalization. Poor health, poor education, and poverty. And we need to break this cycle. And the only way to break this is to create champions. Is to create young people who will move out, who will work, who will get education, who will understand their rights and responsibilities, and work not just for themselves, but for the entire community. And work with the government to do that. Because without government support and intervention, this gigantic problem is not going to go away. It's not a job of one small organization that can bring this change. We are clear about that. We are trying our best to be the catalyst that one could be in the civil society space. We have about 5,673 10 to 19 age group people that we are working with right now. We have 134 champions like Saleha, 72 are girls, 62 are boys. And they take care of different themes in their areas, from water to electricity to cleanliness. Whatever they feel like prioritizing, they do that. They work on them and they work with the government. And very often we get calls from municipality offices that please tell your children, they bother us a lot. And we know we are making some difference, some dent, some change, because they have started speaking about their issues, they have started talking about what to do, when to do, and we don't need to kind of be there all the time for the community. And that's our exit plan. Wherever we start working, the first thing Apnale as an organization we start looking at, thinking about, worrying about is how can we make ourselves redundant? How can we give the community to the people, to the community itself? And in that sense, I feel that adolescence, our intervention, our program is extremely crucial. And I feel completely grateful to Save the Children to have enabled us to do that, to have enabled us to develop programs after programs, and there have never been a partnership like this, despite the fact that we are 43, 44 years old organization. So thank you, Vidisha. And we hope to take it to another level. Now I'm going to hand it over to Pragya. Yeah? Thanks.
So thank you, Arun, and indeed very inspiring. Like they say, change comes really in small pockets as well at times. And it's only fitting to hear our young, inspiring champion, Saliha, and whose story really is, I mean, she will talk more. Ek udhar se request aayi hai ki hum log Hindi, English aur jo Marathi bolte hai, wo thoda mila jula ke bolein. To agar aisa hum Saliha ke baare mein bolein ki wo, uski kahani ek aisi kahani hai, ek journey hai, jo ki Govandi se to be a goalkeeper identified by the UN agencies and Gates Foundation. So literally from Mumbai to Manhattan, Govandi to being a goalkeeper. So I would not hold her from speaking, and you'll hear best as you hear from her. I mean, when she speaks, I think people just fall silent. So I think that's the power of her words. So Saliha, aapko jahan se bhi yahan ke bolna hai, yahan se bol sakte ho, wahan se bolna hai, jo aapko comfortable lage. तो आपकी जर्नी, आपके चैलेंजेस और आपकी उम्मीद क्या है और आगे करने की, थोड़ा अगर उसके बारे आप बात करें. ठीक है, कहाँ से यहाँ हो गए आप?
हेलो, मेरा नाम सालेहा है, मैं गोवंडी से हूँ. पिछले 3 साल से मैं अपनाले के साथ वॉलंटियर कर रही हूँ. तो जैसा कि हमारे पास जब प्रॉब्लम्स होती तब हम उसका सोल्यूशन निकालते, वैसे मेरी कहानी है कि जब मैं 12 साल की थी तो मैं हमारी जो उम्र होती है ना बचपन की, वो हमेशा ऐसे लगती है सिर्फ खेल कूद में. वैसे मैं भी खेलती थी, खेलने के थ्रू मैं अपनाले सेंटर में गई. वहाँ पे मेंस्ट्रुअल हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन्स के ऊपर सेशन चल रहा था पीरियड्स को लेके. तो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि फर्स्ट टाइम मैंने मेंस्ट्रुअल हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन के बारे में सुना, तो मुझे अजीब लग रहा था. बट मुझे उसमें इन्वॉल्व नहीं होने दे रहे थे मैम लोग, बोला कि तुम्हारी एज नहीं है ये. तो मैंने सोचा कि क्यों ना मैं इसमें पार्टिसिपेट करूँ. मुझे अच्छा लगने लगा, वो गेम खेलते थे और कुछ सेशंस वगैरह लेते थे. तो मैं जब वहाँ जाने लगी तो मेरे पेरेंट्स का कहना क्या था कि तू कहीं नहीं जाएगी क्योंकि तेरी उम्र नहीं है ये सब सीखने के लिए. मैंने बोला मम्मी मुझे सीखना है, क्योंकि जब मैं 8th स्टैंडर्ड में थी तो मेरी दीदी की शादी हो गई थी. उन्होंने 9th के बाद उनका शादी कर दिया था. वो आज बहुत सारी हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स क्रिएट हो रही, तो वो मैं नहीं चाहती थी कि मेरे साथ भी वो सब प्रॉब्लम्स क्रिएट हुए. तो मैंने पापा को बोला, घर में खुद एक एग्जांपल है हमारे, देखो कम उम्र में शादी हो गई है उसकी और उसको इतनी सारी हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम हो रही है. अगर उसको होती तो शायद से इतनी हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती. तो मैंने बोला नहीं, मुझे पढ़ना है. फिर वहाँ से मैंने इनिशिएटिव लिया, चाहे कितनी भी प्रॉब्लम हो जाए अपनी प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करना है. फिर मैंने मेरे पापा को बहुत कन्विंस किया, रोती थी बाद में पापा के पीछे खाना खा लेती थी. हाँ, उनके सामने आए थोड़ा सा एक्टिंग करना पड़ता था कि मुझे पढ़ना है भाई. तो मैंने जब अपनी मेरा एडमिशन कराया गया तो मैं बहुत खुश हो गई. पर मैंने सोचा मेरे जैसी और भी मेरी फ्रेंड्स है, उनके पेरेंट्स क्या बोलते थे, हमारा जो रोड है वहाँ से लड़कियाँ जब चल के जाती है तो बहुत सारे लड़के हैं जो इफ्टीजिंग करते हैं, छेड़छाड़, उनके ऊपर कमेंट्स करते हैं. किसी के भी पेरेंट्स रहेंगे, लड़कियाँ हैं तो पेरेंट्स डरते हैं कि लड़कियाँ बाहर कैसे जाएगी, इतनी दूर कैसे जाएगी. तो हम लोगों ने डिसाइड किया क्यों ना हम लोग ग्रुप बना के बाहर जाए स्कूल पढ़ने के लिए. वहाँ से फिर मैंने अपनी फ्रेंड्स के पेरेंट्स से बात की, तो उनका भी कहना क्या था कि मेरी मम्मी को बोलते थे कि तुम्हारी बेटी सबके पेरेंट्स लोग को चढ़ाने आई है, ऐसा वो लोगों का था. मैंने बोला नहीं आंटी ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. तो बोले अच्छा, कोई तुम लोगों को यानी छेड़ेगा तो क्या करोगे, तुम लोग में इतनी ताकत है क्या मार लोगे. हम लोग ने बोला एक मिर्ची की पाउडर रख लेंगे. तो बोला उन लोग के सामने भी बहुत सारी ऐसी, क्योंकि पेरेंट्स ऐसा चीज़ है जो जल्दी कन्विंस नहीं होते, मैम और टीचर बड़ी जल्दी कन्विंस हो जाते हैं. क्योंकि पेरेंट्स को एक अगर मोबाइल भी खरीदना है ना तो एक एग्जांपल देना पड़ता है. तो वैसे एग्जांपल देके मैंने भी आज इस लेवल पे खड़ी हूँ मेरे घर की सपोर्ट की वजह से. तो फर्स्ट में 2017 में मुझे सावित्रीबाई फुले अवार्ड मिला था, जहाँ सभी को महिलाओं को मिलता था जो सोशल वर्क करती है, जो कुछ यानी शादी हो गई उनके बाद भी वो अपना काम कर रही है, कोई बच्चों को पढ़ा रही है. तो वहाँ से सर आए घर पे और इंटरव्यू लिया मेरा, तो मैं वो इंटरव्यू में पास हो गई. तो उन्होंने बोला कि नॉमिनेट किया गया सावित्रीबाई फुले अवार्ड में. तो वहाँ बोला गया कि मम्मी को नहीं लाना, पापा को लाना, क्योंकि मम्मी तो दिन भर घर में रहती, पापा शाम में आते, शायद से पापा को कुछ पता नहीं है जिसके कारण तुमको मना कर रहे बाहर जाने के लिए। जब मैं मेरे पापा को लेके गई, मेरे पापा बैठे थे और मुझे नॉमिनेट किया गया, तो मेरे पापा बहुत खुश हो गए कि फर्स्ट मोमेंट था कि वो स्टेज पे मुझे देख रहे थे। वहाँ से मुझे और हौसला आ गया कि पापा मुझे सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं। आज मेरी फैमिली और मैं साथ में अशोका यूथ वेंचर्स हूँ। यूथ की आवाज़ में जो भी मेरे कम्युनिटी का इश्यूज रहता है, मैं जहाँ मुझे अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती है वहाँ मैं प्रेजेंट करती हूँ। और रिसेंटली मैं न्यूयॉर्क जाके आई, जैसे कि हम सब ने मिलके गोल्स बनाया, 17 गोल्स, तो मेरा इरादा ये है कि मेरी कम्युनिटी में कुछ समय बाद सब लोगों तक का राइट इन्फॉर्मेशन पहुँचे और उनको हर एक को एजुकेशन्स के बारे में, जैसे मेंस्ट्रुअल हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन का है। फिल्म स्टार से जैसे कि अक्षय टिंकर करना क्या है, तो उन्होंने जैसे पैडमैन मूवी बनाई थी, सही में वो सब लोगों ने देखा होगा क्योंकि वो एक सेलिब्रिटी है। अगर वही कम्युनिटी का कोई लड़का करता तो बहुत सारे इश्यूज आते हैं। तो टिंकर खन्ना मैम को मैं बहुत थैंक यू कहना चाहूँगी कि वो इसमें पार्टिसिपेट हुए, हमारी आवाज़ खुद भी बने। तो थैंक यू सो मच। सेव द चिल्ड्रन को तो मैं बहुत बहुत थैंक यू कहना चाहूँगी कि सेव द चिल्ड्रन है इसलिए सब जगह बच्चे उनके दिखते, इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म मुझे दिया है, तो थैंक यू सो मच बच्चों की भी आवाज़ लाने। और एक बात कहना चाहूँगी, ज़िंदगी में कभी किसी को पाने की तमन्ना मत करो, ज़िंदगी में कभी किसी को पाने की तमन्ना मत करो, बल्कि खुद को इस काबिल बनाओ कि लोग तुम्हें पाने की तमन्ना करें।
थैंक यू सलेहा। एंड आई थिंक इट्स रियली, इफ आई कैन बी रियली ऑनेस्ट, एवरी टाइम आई हियर आवर यंग चैंपियंस इट जस्ट ओवरवेल्म्स मी। आई मीन इट्स जस्ट यू नो दैट यू फील दैट एवरीथिंग दैट वी डू एड्स वैल्यू इवन इफ इन दिस रिस्पेक्ट दैट सो दैट दे आर एबल टू स्टैंड हियर एंड स्पीक। आई थिंक you are on the right path and you can really move with a collective of people and partnership that Bidisha you talked about. Twinkle, you have joined us, and I think just four of you sitting on the stage is a perfect combination of what needs to really happen, and just one link is missing, which is the government, and that's the collaboration we are talking about. And you guys are all here, we can't discount you, like the media, because you have to tell stories like these, you know, you have to start telling good news, you have to start talking about successes, you have to talk about the fact that change is possible. Aur aadhi baat to Saleha ne jo boli, jo ki hamare introduction mein bhi humne use kiya, we have saved that our last speaker for so that you can hear her more, because this today it was her first interaction and we are really grateful that you decided to come on board with us. So ek chhota sa introduction humne rakha hai, stage ke logon ko baad mein dikha denge shayad. Twinkle, you have seen it. It's just like a brief over, just summing up your association with us, little bit about you. So we are playing, so we'll share this. And then we'll have Twinkle talk about her journey, because this morning was her first interaction with our who we are as an organization, working with our partners, seeing many more like Saleha out there in the community. So we would like to hear from her as well about her experience. But before that, we would like to play the little snippet that you have from us.
Thank you.
So with that, if we could sort of request Twinkle to talk about your experience today, about your association with the organization, and your hopes as to what you want to change with us about the problems that we are talking about.
And good afternoon, everyone. I would say that my journey with menstrual health began almost 6 years ago, and I started writing in columns about it because just as a woman, I felt that not only were there taboos around me, but there were taboos even within me. I was also one of the girls who would say, I have my period, can I go to a temple, and all of these things. So it wasn't just that I was seeing it outside, it was within. After that, I decided to write a short story on Murugananthamma's life, who's the inventor of the low-cost sanitary pad-making machine. And then I realized that the taboos around menstruation are so widespread that the only way to cut across all kinds of boundaries of culture and economic backgrounds would be to make a movie. In that way, the awareness and the news would spread, and so we made Padman. I still remember a lot of people when I started to make the movie said that, are you crazy? Who's going to watch a movie about menstruation? People don't even talk about it. And that was a challenge, to find people who would even finance a film like this. But I think that as a team, we were very determined and we did that. And soon we realized that every little step you take, you might say that what can a movie do? But we realized the impact because pretty much a month after that, we suddenly saw governments announcing that they are having sanitary pad vending machines in all railway stations. There was an impact on the GST. And somewhere I feel that we did play a small part in bringing that about. Then when I looked at this, I felt that you have to attack a problem from every direction you can. So we did, I mean, I thought I did it through columns and through movies. And then I thought that we needed to do some groundwork. And it was fabulous for me to join Save the Children for two reasons. One, because of the great work they've been doing, and two, because you get to catch people really young, which means that you get to catch them before their habits are ingrained. The other thing that happens is that we realize that 20% of schoolgirls drop out once they hit puberty. Why do they do that? They do that because of the taboo around menstruation, and they do that because they do not have low-cost sanitary pads accessible to them. Just last year, you had a 12-year-old girl in South India who stained her school uniform and her teacher reprimanded her. She didn't drop out of school. She went home, jumped off her balcony and committed suicide. And that's the level of shame that there is around the simple biological function. I feel that it's very important to change mindsets. And what I saw today in Govandi was absolutely gratifying because I saw a peculiar thing. I saw the fact that both Apnale and Save the Children were not just educating girls, they were educating boys. And that is very important because whatever said and done, we still live in a patriarchal society. And the man is still in control of the household. But if he is also understanding a woman's problem, if he's talking about menstruation, then that household is a lot more progressive than it would be if the man was not educated. I'm looking forward to working with young people, interacting with young people, looking at champions like them. It was an experience when you go out to make an impact and you realize how much of an impact, you know, life has made on you. Because I heard marvelous stories. I heard a girl who was saying that she, you know, girls are kept within their households in this community, and she was out there playing kabaddi, and now she wants to play football. And she said, please, will you come for a football match? And it'll mean that so many more girls can join us. And if just my presence would do that, then I think that it would make a big difference, not just me, but from everyone's work. If Saleha can impact 2,500 girls and about how they are reacting with menstrual hygiene, then all of us, I think it's our responsibility to do the same, to make some sort of change. Everyone keeps waiting for someone else to save the world, but I think it's up to all of us. We all have the cape, we all have the capability as well, and we should go ahead. That's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. So I think we are all in this journey to impact change and together. So with that, we have another 5-7 minutes to field any question that media friends here have. And we would like to keep it really focused on the issue at hand. So just a kind of sincere request that if we could talk about the issue, the data, our work, questions to our panelists here. and our speakers and our artist ambassador. So over to you, Geeta. Could we have you moderate the questions? Any questions?
Any questions that anybody has, specific questions? My question is for Twinkle Khanna, ma'am. I'm from Mumbai Live. My question is, how exactly are you going to associate it with Save the Children and Apna Le?
I think one of the primary things that I would have to do is they have their champions, and I would like to amplify the voices of these young champions. I think that is my main job, and to spread awareness about the cause. If my voice can reach a few more people, then Save the Children could reach on their own, then I think that is a job that I would have done well.
Any other questions? Okay, I think okay. We can just wrap it up.
So thank you so much for coming. So before you leave, we would like you to join us for IT. And yeah? So please don't go without. Thank you so much. And we do hope to see more stories and many more stories tomorrow on the issue of dollars and tell. Do you have a question? Do you have a question? Okay.
Twinkle ma'am, my question is, how was the experience today? You have met some children also. How was the experience meeting with them?
I look at all of them, and there were so many of these champions there. And what was remarkable is the fact that they were filled with confidence. They were more, and you know, an adolescent is a very strange creature. It's a creature who has a lot of neurosis at that point of time. But these were boys and girls who were so confident and determined. And also, what I really felt and moved by was the fact that they were convinced that they could actually bring about a change. The cynicism that we have as adults is not in them. And that was very gratifying to watch. मेरे हिसाब से अगर आपके पास एक प्लेटफॉर्म है तो आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होती है कि आप उसे यूज़ करें किसी और को हेल्प करने क्योंकि अगर आपको लाइफ ने कुछ दिया है आपको कुछ वापस देना ही चाहिए ये मेरा बिलीफ है और यही कॉज नहीं लेकिन हर जगह पे और हर हिसाब से इन स्मॉल वेज एंड लार्ज वेज इफ़ यू कैन गिव बैक देन इट्स अ लाइफ वर्थ वाइल अदरवाइज यू नो यू आर जस्ट एन एनिमल रोमिंग अराउंड लाइक एवरी वन एल्स No, I think it's really changing. We've had a lot of movies about, you know, different social problems. And we've also had Toilet, Ek Prem Katha, which, by the way, 19th November is World Toilet Day. And the good news is that India finally, in 2018, has toilet coverage of 95%, which means, you know, we are finally in love with our toilets and are using them, hopefully. So I think that movies make an impact, and I think people are very open to it. You have movies about all sorts of things. I mean, and they're doing rather well. So I don't think that that is a very sort of stringent attitude that the industry has.
Twinkle, ma'am. Oh, yeah. Yeah, ma'am.
Yes.
I really appreciate Akshay Kumar ji and you, that you are on the giving side to the society. I just want to know how this project will take ahead as a brand ambassador.
I will continue working in the directions that I'm asked to work in to amplify voices, to spread awareness, to do some groundwork, to interact with children, so that not only am I, you know, impacting their lives, but I also want to learn from them. Because it's, even today, the little experience I had has left me with something that I really want to think about. I met so many children with so many stories. I also met one man who came and said, you know, I'm the Akshay Kumar of my community. So I was like, why? What do you do? I mean, do you do karate? He's like, no, I build toilets. So that was really wonderful, you know, to meet so many people and to see their stories.
I think we'll just take one last question from that corner.
Twinkle ji, mera ek sawal hai aap se ki...
Sir, can we give one chance to the lady also there, please?
Since I'm here at this platform, I would tell you that being a woman or being a man is a physical state. Our minds are androgynous. So we as women must not let our biology hinder us in any way possible. And that is my message to them.
Twinkle, ma'am, my question is that people of menstruation think that you are unpavitra at that time. Do you think women become unpavitra? What is your opinion? What is your thoughts on that?
I would like Saliha to answer
that. अब पवित्र क्यों मानना चाहिए? हमारी कम्युनिटी में भी है ऐसा. बहुत सारी महिला है जो किताब नहीं पढ़ती है. उनकी जो रहती है वो किताब नहीं पढ़ती. पर उनको ये बताना चाहिए ये हमारा नेचुरल ही है. वो हर मंथ आएगा तो क्या हम कहीं जा नहीं सकते, कुछ खा नहीं सकते? ऐसे बहुत सारे महिलाओं के थॉट रहते. तो उनको अभी बताना चाहिए कि आजकल की जो जनरेशन है हर जगह जा रही है, हर जगह घूम रही है.
ट्विंकल जी,
हम एक एक करके सवाल पूछें. That's absolutely rubbish. There's nothing to even discuss that, you know, why are they thinking like this? It's an absolutely simple biological function, the most important, because none of you would exist if that wasn't happening in our bodies.
Twinkle ji, aakhri sawal ye ki hum dekh rahe hain ki in dino dheron sare star kid launch ho rahe hain and RO ke upar bhi logon ki nazar hai, to kya hum aisa mane ki wo bhi acting mein aayenge ya fir aap aur Akshay
चिल्ड्रेन को बोलूंगी मेरे बच्चे को भी सेव करने. बस थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू. सो विद दैट वी क्लोज एंड वी वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज. हाँ हाँ हाँ, ले लीजिए फोटो यहाँ पे दोबारा से. थैंक यू.
सेंटर सेंटर मैम,
थैंक यू
थैंक यू थैंक यू
थैंक यू. मैं सो लो
सो जा.
अरे नागरी बोल रहे
मैम,
दिस साइड
सेंटर में. सेंटर में सेंटर में सेंटर में मैम, सेंटर
बोला मैम. यहाँ पे नहीं देखा लेफ्ट में
मैम. यहाँ
मैम सेंटर
मैम.
यहाँ सेंटर मैम लेफ्ट साइड. यहाँ थैंक
यू थैंक यू थैंक यू
And now I want to do some groundwork with Save the Children. I want to interact with these young minds and hopefully make a little bit of a change in their mindsets, their ideologies, and I'm looking forward to that.
Do we see after any kind of coming forward for this?
Why don't you bring him here, or I'll, you know, probably disguise myself and you can ask him these questions.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah,
yes.
Done?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't.
नहीं, कोई रिसर्च और पर्सनालिटी नहीं है. आई फील कि अगर हमें एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिला है तो एक उसके साथ एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी भी जुड़ती है कि हम जितना कर सके दूसरों के लिए वो करें, क्योंकि लाइफ इज इनहेरेंटली अनफेयर, बट मे बी ईच पर्सन कैन डू देयर बिट टू मेक इट अ लिटिल बिट मोर फेयर. That's all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.